Hey Tubers, Big Kid here of Big Kid Reviews and many more. Today we're back working on this Swisher 54 inch zero turn mower. Made a video before of this tower bearing going out. This one's on the right hand side of the mower, which is the same one I replaced in the last video in 2014, October. And this is ridiculous. This was a Swisher part, high dollar Swisher part. And look in there, I'll try to get turned. Look how galled up that is inside that shaft. And no grease to speak of, and look at the shaft here, how torn up that is. Just ridiculous. Everything in there fell out on the floor when I got this, when I took the pulley off. This comes up through the shaft like this, and this is how it sets, and the pulley's on here. This bolts down into there and bolts to the mower deck. And there goes my air compressor. But as soon as I took that nut, the pulley off, well, the whole thing just dropped down. I was gonna unscrew the blade from this this mounting plate here, and it's screwed onto this shaft, and then a safety bolt is through the center of it. So the way that I can, only way I could get that off was to take off the pulley and then use a pipe wrench up here, knowing that the thing was bad, and take it off. I guess it would be possible to tap gently on that and drive that shaft out of all that bearing if it wasn't tore up, but you know, you take a chance on damaging the threads. You can sometimes put a nut on there and leave it covering, protecting the threads, and tap real gentle and maybe get that out of there. But when it's making racket, there's obviously something wrong. And sure enough, the thing quit cutting. I was trying to just finish that little bit extra before I got quit the other day, and it just didn't make it. It quit cutting, and this is what happened. It threw the belt off, and so we take it apart for the second time. Now this mower, I've had, I don't know, maybe 2008, 2009, I don't remember. When the first bearing first went out, it only had 77 clock hours, because where we lived, I didn't have but less than an acre of property, and that's including the house and the shop and the garden and the fence and all the other stuff. So it didn't get a use a lot, but 77 hours and this right bearing went out. Replaced it when we moved to Texas in October of 14, and nearly the end of October, and here we are. Here is the 2017, and it's just the end of April. So 2 years and the same tower goes out. Now we got two more towers, the left one and the center one, and they're original, same amount of hours. What's going on here? Today is Saturday, and come Monday, I'll call Swisher and record the phone call about how come their crap is so sorry. But in the meantime, the Swisher bearing from the Swisher factory is like $20 more than what I found it somewhere else. So I went on and ordered it. Hopefully it'll go out right away and I won't have my lift down and my mower down and everything else. And the grass growing like weeds, you know. So just thought I'd make a video and show you how crappy the factory Swisher stuff is. And from the looks of the paint job on this tower housing and the splatters on the weld, I'd say this was probably made in China or Taiwan or somewhere. That doesn't look like it was made in the USA. If it was, they didn't get their money's worth. So, I'll keep you posted when I get the new part and see what we do then. But this is just awful. I don't think I'll be buying another Swisher lawnmower. Says made in the USA. Well, I don't know. I just find it hard to believe that all the parts are made here. All right. Well, if hit that like button and share and comment and whatever you'd like to do, and I'll put a link to where I found some bearings. So, see you on the next video or on the next clip. Thank you. Well, I had to make another clip, tubers. We got the part in, and they wasted 2 days because the idiots on the site that I ordered from did not say they were a non-stocking dealer and would drop ship it. So I ended up having the factory called and informed me they couldn't ship to a P.O. box because they shipped FedEx or UPS. Well, you know, they didn't say that on the site, so it cost me an extra 2 days. Boy, customer service sucks. These people always, all they want is your damn money. They don't want to give you no information. Their shopping cart sucks. They should have put on there that, you know, they shouldn't have been able to take a shipping address of a P.O. box. We do have a business address is our P.O. box, because our physical address, the P.O. box, the mailbox is out on a state highway, and you know that's about as secure as handing out $100 bills out of a cigar box saying only take one or something. That's just stupid, insane. The smart post people always ship to the post office, then give it to the post office to make delivery, so it's bullshit that they will not ship to a PO, to a post office. Just freaking insane. You didn't have to sign for it, so that's beside the point. So anyway, the factory said, well, for my troubles, they send 2 bearings. Well, they didn't. They sent one assembled system, and they sent the worthless damn bearings that go in that end and that end. Well, what good is that? Let me show you. I don't know if the light will get it or not. Let me play with it just a little bit here. Maybe I can walk over under a light and let you see the problem why these bearings are failing. Even though Swisher claims the fame is made in the USA, look at the damn parts. China. Made in China. That's where the bearings are. $80 for this damn thing. It consists of 2 bearings. I'm not sure that's going to come in or not, but they're both China. And the bearings they sent, guess what? China. And it doesn't do a damn bit of good to have those bearings, because look at this old one. When the bearings failed, it took out the shaft. And I think on the previous clips I showed you how galled the assembly is. So there's no way you can put bearings in there. It won't work. Unless you're just changing these bastards out every year. And who's going to do that? I certainly don't want to have to do it. And this blade lock is threaded on to this shaft, and it is right-hand threads, in case you're wondering. And I put clamped this part in the vise and used a pipe wrench on here to break it loose. But you know, it ain't gonna matter, because that isn't reusable anyway. So I just had to make you a video and show you. My recommendation, don't buy Swisher. You know, buy something else. And before you buy a lawnmower, number one is check to see what you have to do to change the oil. This thing here, this 54-inch ZT54 or whatever Swisher, I've had it for a while, but the thing is, the other two bearings, you have a front one, which they call the center, and then you got two outside, one on the left and one on the right, and they're the same, but that one in the middle is a different assembly. They're still running. And this is the second time I've had to replace the right one. So, piss poor. And I bought this because it was supposed to be semi-industrial quality, commercial grade, and it has an oil filter. That's an important thing. Buy you a mower with an oil filter on it, but check on what you got to do to change the oil. If it's some kind of special adapter and you got to disassemble stuff and build things, don't buy it. Just buy something else. If they don't have it plumbed already to get the oil out, you know, why pay that kind of money? This thing was, list price was $4,000, and we got it at the end of the season, so it got a little cheaper, but still, my goodness, this mower has got 70 something hours on it, and I'm already on my second bearing for this side over here. Just utterly ridiculous. So Swisher's claiming they are made in America is total bullshit. All right, well, I'll put her back together and maybe make another clip of it when I get her all back. But that's my two cents worth, and hit that subscribe button and share, like, or make comments, do whatever. And I'd sure like to post this to their Facebook account, but I bet you they wouldn't let me do that. But I will go make a comment on their Facebook account, both the carpet and that SL whatever the hell place is I bought it from, provided they allow it. They probably won't. But this is a big kid. See you on the next video, and many more to come, hopefully. All right, see you on the next video. Bye. Hey tubers, I had to make another clip here to show you and what kind of issues you get into when you're trying to use the owner's manual or parts manual that came with your mower, or anything for that matter, and you fall for the validity of the thing. In an earlier video a couple of years ago about replacing these blades and the bearing tower, it got into a problem with the blades, and that I found the part number was incorrect in my manual. It listed the part number as 3293, when in fact the part number is 14326. And that, if it hadn't been for me paying close attention to the descriptions, I wouldn't have found that. And then I finally called Swisher Factory and got that confirmed. Well, here we are again. And what happened then is, the first time that tower bearing, this is the right, well, that's the outside driver assembly here. It didn't completely tear it up like it did this time. I actually took it apart and took the parts off and set them aside and put it back together as it came apart. But this time the whole thing fell on the floor when I took this nut off of this
pulley here. Well, this whole thing, the shaft, all the bearing pack, what was left, which was very little, fell out of this spindle housing. The blade and everything fell down. So when I all of the stuff up in here came completely apart. So when I was putting it back together, I followed this diagram, and as you can see here on the out driver, which is the left or the right, is showing one washer, a number 8, I believe here. Yes, and then you go up to the parts list, and a number 8 is right here. And it's the, if I can make my book stand still, the number 8 is a 3/4 by 1 3/4 flat washer. Okay, now I put it together like that, and the bearing was locked. I mean, with no belt on this thing, when I snugged these three bolts up to hold the blade on, it wouldn't turn. And so I was at a loss as to what was going on. And up here at the top, before you put the pulley on, it shows 2 of the smaller washers. So one of those was completely eaten up by this bearing when it came about. This race for this bearing just chewed that thing all to pieces. So I happen to have in my parts supply some things to make it work. I actually took the washer from the top and put it down there. I had one of these that would work, and I took this one and put it down, even though it was a little bit of a different size. And matter of fact, it's labeled incorrectly too, part number 2, and it's got a, well, it doesn't list the size, it just says it's a Belleville washer, Bellerville, and it's beveled somewhat, kind of like a lock nut, a lock washer would be, but it's not split. So anyway, I used that, and then I put a great big flat washer up here that, and took that, took care of that issue. But down here I put it together like it said, and it was locked up tighter than Hogan's goat. So I loosened it, and it until it would turn, and it was obviously it was compressing against this bottom bearing race and the outside of the spindle some sort of way. So I got to looking over here at the center tower, how it's built, and there's actually 2 washers, a small one and a larger one. And I said, well, considering that they had these parts wrong for the blade, perhaps this is what needs to be done on all of them, is to put 2 washers. So I took it all apart again for the third time and added another washer here and put it all back together, and it worked. The blade spun freely like it should. So there again, the book that came with this thing is totally wrong and will get you in trouble. And the only time it, only reason it worked the first time is it didn't completely destroy all this, and as I took it apart, I set those parts aside and put it back together just like it had come apart. So word to the wise, you know, boy, I'll tell you, it's just amazing how many problems there are with this thing. And even though they claim they're made in America, and I'm going to show you the website of where I got the parts, and a picture of the website for Swisher on the next clip. I'm going to have to change this from the close focus and to the far focus, so we'll be back in a minute. Well, I'm going to pull this up on a computer. This might be easier for you to see. Here are the 2 washers that is on the inside driver, and then on the outside driver, this is the newest manual they put out. See, it's still just showing this one washer here, but it will not work with that bearing assembly that they sent me like that. It just would not work. It's showing two up here. On this one, it's showing two at the top, but and two at the bottom, different sizes. On the supposedly the outer shaft, it's showing just one. So even on the updated version, it's not current, not what's going on in real life. And I wanted to see if I could show you this right here. Made in the USA since 1945, and these people are in Warrensburg, Missouri. This is the Swisher factory. Let me take that down, take this down, and get the Swisher company back. They, well, it's pretty much useless on their site, but where I had ordered this bearing from was this SLE place. Now, they are in Tennessee. Get down here in Antioch, Tennessee. But nowhere on their site do they say that they drop ship. Maybe they don't drop ship everything, but they did drop ship the bearing. And the shopping cart sucks, as we discussed earlier. It doesn't tell you that they don't do P.O. boxes. It don't tell you that they drop ship. The Swisher site's no better. So, it is what it is. I think I'm pretty much done with the Swisher people. If I ever buy another more, it won't be one of theirs. I'm going to call them and express my displeasure to them again. So if I don't make another clip, we'll see you on the next video. Sorry it was so long, but I thought it was pretty important that we make sure that you didn't make the same mistake. If you order anything from this SLE people, record your call and be sure and talk to somebody. Make damn sure they have it in their grimy little hands and that it'll go to where you want it to go. Alright, hit that subscribe button, like, share, and all those good things. Big kid to see you on the next one. Thank you.